Bravo. Last one.
Guy McCree still alongside Adam Bobrow here, taking you through the action on the Infinity Arena. Second straight event here in the European Summer Series. These two have met. This time it's a quarterfinal. Last week, of course, it was the round of 16. And the star contender. Talked about it a bit earlier, didn't we? I think it's worth referencing. We're getting new viewers all the time. Just get your views on this a bit. In terms of a recent meeting and your thoughts on that, the impact it can have when, again, here they're playing each other again relatively soon in the context of things.
Yeah, I think the professionals are not only professional athletes, but mentally they prepare in a way that's so professional and mature that they, as we talked about, have to come to the table with a sense of belief. So maybe it's a different preparation. Maybe it's you come in with different notes, a very different game plan. Now, one thing we haven't talked about yet is that Miu Kihata on her backhand has short pips. For those of you newer to table tennis, pips are those bumps that look like Legos. The longer they are, the more defensive they are. Hello, Peng Bin, coach for Miu Kihata. Part of the reason she speaks such good Chinese for a Japanese athlete. So the short pips used in that rally, what it means is that the ball gets less spin in general. So she tends to play a flatter shot with the backhand. It's a lower trajectory, a little bit less of a high percentage shot than her forehand.
Yeah, for those newer, again, similar to Ami Morita, you were making the point earlier.
Right, and so it's tough to rally with. Wang Yidi is incredibly well prepared. She has spinny rubber on both sides, no pips out. Unlike Kihata, who only has them on the backhand. And a good tight serve here. Shovel serve, nice and tight, behind the net on the forehand side.
Easy does it. Cuts the gap to two.
I'd like to be able to sit in with one of the players in theory, just as a fly on the wall when they're taking their notes. They're studying video footage the night before a big match.
6-5.
And it's generally so much more available now as well, if you think about it. All these matches with the growth of the sport, world table tennis, all the streaming, of course, we've been bringing you from this European Summer Series, the YouTube, in addition to our main coverage. Last week, of course, the star contender on the table won, and here on the Infinity Arena, just so much more available to analyze and evaluate.
100%. I mean, at any playing hall, if you go to the dining hall, rather, during an event, half of the players are on YouTube preparing for their matches.
Oh, that's nicely done.
Backhand bullets. That's 5 points in a row for Miu Kihata. And look how quick these backhands are. Again, the wrist. She just puts the elbow out and creates that cave for the backswing.
And it's not easy to do, as we often point out, against these elite members of the Chinese national team to win those types of trades.
I am just so impressed. Again, there have been a few Japanese stars that have used pips on the backhand side of different lengths, but of course, Mima Ito, as you mentioned, a very stingy backhand punch.
Oh, going through a purple patch here on the Infinity Arena at the moment, Miu Kihara.
Just fitting the color scheme of the WTT champions. Stat on screen there, just to remind you, 8 of the last 8 points for Japan's Miu Kihara.
And that half shake of the head from Wang Yidi. She's been ambushed here in this opening game. Started well. Now Kihara, 4 game points. That is incredible. Run of points through to the opening game. You're going to struggle, I think, this week to see a better series of points than that there from Miu Kihara. That was outstanding. 11-6 and she's ahead.
Another fun road trip conversation is the difference between the domination of the Chinese leaders in the men's game versus the women's game. And quite frankly, the women are simply more dominant than the men. And I think this event is a clear example of that, looking at who's been eliminated already. Only one Chinese male left on the men's side.
Trying to make it a 4 out of 4 here into the semis. But at the moment, Wang Yidi has a problem to solve.
Fortunately for Wang Yidi, she's got quite a bit of time on this problem solving and the skills to do it. Nice to see a mix of brands in the hands of the players there. Saw the Victas racket of Miu Kihata. Good serve to set up and pop up that third ball. Put the pressure on. Kihata's going to be looking for slightly lower or more specific receives to keep Wang Yidi under pressure.
Three all. Just haven't been seeing that lately too often.
What's that we haven't been seeing?
Well, Wang Yidi win a backhand, lose a backhand to backhand trade with a non-Chinese opponent.
It's funny, in game one for the second half, that streak.
Yeah. Oh.
It's incredible, the quality in these rallies.
Yes.
I was going to say the streak of backhands that Miu Kihata was able to put together. She was just so consistent with these very low percentage shots. And then the question is, are they really low percentage shots if someone's making them a high percentage of the time consistently? For everyone else, yes. For Miu Kihata, no. It's her bread and butter.
Let's for all.
Good response. Initially up against it, you felt Wang Yidi.
No, I thought Miu Kihata did a lot of things right in this point. Soft shot, very shallow on the table there, but it sat up just enough, and Wang Yidi did a good job of being patient and moving in. The face of Miu Kihata there was priceless, saying, you got this. You can do it aggressively.
You know, win or lose the point, she's invariably smiling.
Yeah, she does have a very, what is it, resting angel face? I think her default is just sort of positive all the time. She's an optimist through and through.
Four, seven.
Maybe on the towel break, there's a short Doha story with her and Miu Nagasaki.
Okay. Noted.
So here we are. They had just won a title as a women's doubles pair. Miu Kihata, famously known before with Miu Nagasaki for her doubles before really coming through in singles. They were taking a selfie, but the camera was faced the wrong way, and so when they turned the camera around, I was just there, and they freaked out.
Oh. Again, underlines how well Kihara is performing here.
I don't know about you, but thinking about game one, I start to wonder how many times can Miu Kihata repeat the type of turnaround she had in game one?
Especially against someone of this level and confidence, form, Wang Yidi.
I think confidence is the perfect word. Look at that angle she plays, really just flirting with the edge of the table there. That's not an easy place to hit.
Three,
Oh, no.
6-9.
Okay, a couple of surprising shots there. Expected Kihara to make hers, and especially expected Wang to make that one.
Yeah, a few surprising shots in a row. A little bit off the top of the net there, but both of her serves the last 2 points set her up well for that third ball opportunity. That third ball opportunity. It makes me so happy to see Ma Lin. It's just a good feeling. That last one was too good. The rally, she worked hard, Kihara, to get back into the table. She was in position, short strokes. And Wang Yidi sees the opening there, and the parallel forehand, that's the short side of the table, it earns her 3 game points.
Eight, ten.
That's the first of them gone.
It's also the first strawberry I think we've seen from Yu Kihara.
Yeah, the Japanese players, of course, known for their variations on receive. Think of Mima Ito, Hina Hayata as well.
Interestingly enough, the most famous strawberry player, the strawberry farmer, is also a Miyu. Miyu Kato.
Wang Yidi goes on to level this up. Second game points, the one for her. And now one each here with Miyu Kihara. Second, 11-8. Kihara here to begin game number 3.
Love one.
Both of us with our heads nodding as in, that's the shot that made this a tight match.
Well, it wasn't there really last time. We looked at the match just a few days ago. That wasn't there. I mean, that's just trying to look at this points of difference from when they met in the star contender. Right, Adam, that just shot, that just wasn't effective. I mean, she couldn't bring it into play, but different story so far tonight.
It's tough not to love the style. Someone who can be so aggressive and still, with that wide base and the stance, just be comfortable in different parts of the court, show good footwork. Even the wide forehand balls come back fast.
Three, two.
That's a tough one for Miyu Kihara. It was a great setup. Fortunate escape here for Wang Yidi.
That's about as non-smiley as you get from Kihara.
I didn't even recognize her. I was like, who's in this match? Wang Yidi? I remember the other one's from Japan.
First time I've seen that, where she's just coming around into the forehand corner, glances, and then, I mean, there that's caught the tape, but it's pushed, it's glanced long as well, Wang Yidi.
I think it was a very uncomfortable position, and it left her realizing there wasn't a great option. She thought maybe the backhand punch would be the most efficient stroke in that moment. But as we could see, it was very tough from that position to convert.
Right in this match, Miyu Kihara at this stage. And again, I said that about the meeting a few days ago where Wang was in control throughout, really.
How does Wang Yidi cover the middle on that first shot, the backhand punch? Watch this. One right there. I mean, that would have hit her in the rib cage had she not moved, and she got a counter loop back against a short pip flat bullet.
Tried to change up there because nothing was doing on that occasion, going wide into Wang Yidi's backhand, trying to change.
This rally's so fast. Previously, pre-pandemic, the ITTF Star Awards, as we come into a timeout, I was going to say we used to see a lot of points with the top women in the world of that caliber of speed. And from that camera angle, just incredible how fast it is.
It's been quite a day so far, these quarterfinals. Kind of backs up the whole setup, really, of this premium event. These top players going head-to-head. A lot of tight matches.
Yeah. I don't know if I've ever called myself a table tennis adrenaline junkie, but today I feel like it.
I think a lot of people would describe you that way, Adam.
It's tough not to be watching today. Beautiful counter here. Topspin comes in. The perfect read, the angle and everything. Confidence, free-flowing Miu Kiyota. Look at that side brushing backhand. That's what sets up the slower spinny shot from Wang Yidi. Talk about seizing the opportunity.
Oh, it's so good.
7-0.
Shape as well. I mean, change of speed there, but length as well from Kiyota. It's not like she's just trying to bludgeon away cross table there. There's smarts in that.
Abs, I couldn't agree with you more. At 17 years old, she's playing years beyond in terms of wisdom. Now, when you're playing against players who can be so deadly in the punch game, like Miu Kihara, like Nima Ito, I feel like while China would be the team to study it and figure out the answer, for me it was actually Du Hoi Kim.
7-9.
That was the Austrian Open victory over Nima Ito right after she swept everything from several Chinese top athletes. They spin it deep on the table and it makes it tough to punch back.
7-7.
For example.
Indeed.
Doesn't always have to be the fastest shot, just low and deep. Now 3 game points for Wang Yidi.
Oh, take that, she says.
Oh, man, that's just too pretty. The brush, the backhand, beautiful coverage, counterattacks, the punches start coming out, the step around, and the flat hit kill
shot. Enough, she
says.
This is ending, and so it did. Bang. No, not that time. Wang Yidi is in a match here, but still finding herself 2-1 to the good now on Miu Kihara in this remaining quarterfinal. Fascinating at the moment, actually, watching Kihara's performance. Adam, a point you were making on the commentary earlier, discussing other members of the Chinese national team, but just in overview, these two leading nations in the women's game and their picks for big events going forward. Oh, finds the angle there. Talking a lot about the Chinese national team, their picks, because there's so many options. Look at this, meanwhile.
Yeah, Japan rolls pretty deep in the women's game as well. I think they're actually more professional women than men in Japan.
One, two.
Yeah, Akihara, with her rate of improvement, the performance level she's putting on here tonight. It's those road trip conversations you're talking about again here. This is another one, I think.
I agree. That's a very fun conversation. And you're right. Rate of improvement. I mean, it's like, you know, you're throwing the ball to where the person's running. And at the steep incline of her improvement by Paris 2024, will she be a contender? Beautiful change of pace here. Miu Kihara just cutting that ball down to size, dropping it behind the net and forcing Wang Yidi to move in.
First tail break. Yeah, I mean, with Team China, you've got Xia Xia, you've got Wang Manyu there, but I mean, Wang Yidi at the moment is putting a case together. Well, then there's the others.
Right. Well, Chen Meng and Wang Yidi right now,
didn't even
four.
Mention Chen Meng.
Yeah, so these are the four that are the big players in the conversation right now.
4-3.
My guess is the three that play for the team for Paris will be three of those four, possibly with one on the bench. But we still have some time before all that. And as you mentioned, with the rate of improvement, also with injuries and other things, I mean, for Chen Meng, she's incredible. She just came out of the number one spot in the world, could be back fairly soon. But she's not getting any younger.
Oh, well, good reach from Kihara, but then into the open space, Wang. Take the point.
That ball right there, it's not the first time we've seen her do that this match. It's a very unusual shot. And even more impressive to me is that Wang Yidi doesn't seem bothered by that straight side spin shot.
Just interesting to see a player here often talk about that backhand to backhand as well, and trying to pin the forehand as she's done a few times as well. A player to be able to do that to a banging form Chinese national team member. That last one slipping by.
I just can't help myself but laugh at how fast the ball is going back and forth.
Yeah. Again, as we always say, try and watch this if you can. Get some tickets, watch live as well, because however brilliantly we can, our production team, do it for you on TV, it's nothing like being in the arena. It's unparalleled, really, in the ability to witness the speed of attacks, the ball, and these athletes in general.
7-5.
A lot of different camera angles in the game, but in rallies like this, for me, these fast, flat shots from Miu Kihara, I think that camera angle from the side is actually nearly perfect to demonstrate the speed. And it's nice for perspective change just to see it from down here as well. In terms of youth, who you choose for the big events like the Olympics, I think experience under pressure is a big thing, and Sun Yingxia showed from quite a young age that she could handle. This is big for Wang Yidi.
7-0.
Firing it back at her. Excellent counter, if you like, from Miu Kihara. You know, it's losses. You've often used this phrase over the years, and it's losses to foreigners as well in the scheme of things. Because ultimately, what are you doing at the Olympic Games? What have you got to do to go through there? You've only got the two picks in singles. And so these are big moments, you know, in a way, in this match. As you say, can you keep your composure, play your best stuff in those big moments when you're being tested?
Funny, the term foreigner really is relative to who's speaking and where you are, but in table tennis, I feel like it just means not China.
Yes.
7-9.
There's almost no other application for the word foreigner in table tennis, really. Losses to foreigners, it doesn't mean anything outside of the Chinese national team. What would that mean anywhere else? Look at the scoreboard now.
Mm. Oh, would you believe it? Magical Mew there. That was incredible.
A leg sweep drop into the ground. This is really taking a gamble. Flat kill shot. It was low. That must have been about net height, and it sets up 3 game points to send this to the decider.
Oh. Maybe you would have thought that was enough. Wang had other ideas.
Yeah, that's a gutsy shot. Backhand punch right at the baseline. A little break there to stay alive.
2 more game points, and with the service. And that's the one. Kihara levels with Wang. And this remaining women's quarterfinal is going to a fifth and deciding game.
Love all.
Yeah, not top 10 for nothing. Look how cool that was. You see what she just did? A ghost lob comes right back to her and catches it on the racket. Swag. Back edge of the table for Kihara.
Yeah, deserves the good fortune. The way she's playing here, taking it on, staying true to her aggressive instincts. And that run, of course, through to the fourth, first point of this fifth. 7 of the last 8 now for Kihara.
1 love. One all.
And doing it all, still doing it all as always, with a smile breaking through there.
Yeah, a little bit of wryness in that one. After a decent opportunity to take a 2-0 lead on her first 2 serves, Wang Yidi doing a good job of changing the rhythm there, slowing it down and spinning it so it catches the edge of the racket. Also caught Miu Kihara not taking the flat kill.
2-1.
So go deeper there, go longer, fast, long serve. That's no impact for Wang.
Yeah, that's excellent patience on the receive, Miu Kihara.
Oh, such a high level. This is so good to watch.
Yeah, it really takes such a combination out here of shots. Just a whole army of incredible balls, one after another, for a chance at winning the point. I mean, Kihara came around the backhand corner for one, still played a big shot, recovered from it.
4-2.
Sort of like that, except it was on the table and she recovered. Few steps away here, but good placement from Wang Yidi to really force Miu Kihara out of her comfort zone on that backhand corner.
Flat 4-2.
Oh, yeah, that was a chance.
Didn't miss by a lot, but that wrist, looking for that strawberry-like mid-rally shot. There it is. It's one. And again, nope, goes for the punch. Something in between, though. Not much rotation on that first receive. So they've switched sides, as this is the final game, and one player has 5 points.
2-6.
I guess the decider, I should say.
Yeah, it was the run of...
That was a cool catch there. I don't know if you
this
saw
is,
that.
We're just confirming this is actually the same as the score, but it's six, those last 8 points.
That is a funny coincidence, sort of cool, easy to camouflage that stat. I don't know if you saw before, Miyu Kihata caught the ball with two fingers like chopsticks. It was impressive. They threw her the ball and she just, yeah, like scissors even.
Timeout.
Marlin's decided this is the moment to use the timeout here with Wang Yidi 3 points clear in the decider.
We'll have a chance to see it. I think the assistant umpire threw the ball to Miyu Kihata. After all this description, I'm sure you're quite excited. We'll see. I might have to be more vivid in my description for you. So back from the timeout, 3 points down.
Is this possibly slipping away from Kihara now? It's been a really brave performance. I say brave because of how aggressive she's been throughout and has stuck with it.
Yeah,
through thick and thin.
Right, she's played a really risky, high-risk game, taking her chances. You do have to force yourself to do that sometimes because it's uncomfortable. Now, on the timeout, from what I could hear of Ma Lin, basically taking your chances, spinning the ball. Don't be afraid. There was a lot of encouragement. No problem. You got this. Don't be afraid. Spin.
Unbelievable. Again from Kihara. That chop in there.
Yeah, that brushing backhand to really mix it up. Side and what else?
Whoa.
Underspin on it. Takes a wicked turn.
Vicious.
And comes back into the net. Yeah.
Just keeps her in touch, doesn't it, with the serves to come. That creative moment from the Japanese.
Oh no!
4-9.
That's a heartbreaker when you've already got a 4-point deficit, but what an escape. Quick acknowledgement from Wang Yidi. This is such a good setup. If that ball hits the clean top of the table, Miyu Kihata's got breakfast ready.
9-5.
Yeah, it's harsh there, because as you say, just a fraction shorter, and she's back there to 8-6, as it is. Lead of 4 for Wang here, and the service to come to try and close this out. What's been a thoroughly watchable contest. It's maybe still got some way to run. Punch, is it back there? Straight through and flat.
A bit off the top of the net, some karma maybe from the back edge.
Repeat the dose.
6-10.
Wang has been well and truly tested here, but with 4 match points now to close, try and close Kihara out. The win streak continues here for Wang Yidi, but that's some test she survived. Her opponent, Miyu Kihara, you're going to see an awful lot more of going on and on. The 17-year-old played a great match, but comes up short in the fifth. Wang completes an all-Chinese semi-final lineup here in Budapest in this inaugural WTT Champions European Summer Series with that win.